So I got this Alabaster box at church. I know I'm supposed to put money, but I don't really know what it means. Maybe I should ask Rachel. Rachel, what does Alabaster mean?
Alabaster? I think it means something about a jar, perfume, stuff like that. I don't really know. I'm kind of busy. Can you go ask Daniel?
A jar? Perfume?
Yeah, something like that. Can you hand me that blue pencil? Thanks. Hey Daniel, what does alabaster mean?
Alabaster? It's something about building churches and spreading the gospel. But I'm too busy to do it right now. Go us back up.
Building churches? Spreading the gospel?
Oh yeah, and ham and chips.
Hey Becca, what does alabaster mean?
It's an offering. You give up something valuable to help others. I'm too busy. Go ask Dad.
An offering? Something valuable?
Yeah, speaking of which, can you hand me that kid?
Dad, what is alabaster about?
Alabaster? It's like a rock and you carve with it. But you know, I'm kind of busy right now. Could you go talk to your mother?
A rock? Okay.
Hey, Anna, could you hand me that 15 millimeter wrench right there?
Okay.
Thank you.
Honey, can't you see I'm making dinner? It's the story of when a woman took a jar of very expensive perfume. She broke it and she poured it on Jesus' feet. The disciples were upset because it was really expensive perfume, but Jesus recognized the sacrifice and beautiful gift that it was.
Now we use the alabaster offering to share our riches with people all around the world. Helping to build churches, schools, medical buildings, homes for missionaries, anywhere there's a need.
We give above and beyond as a sacrifice, just like the woman did when she broke the perfume.
So this box is like the jar made of alabaster. If I put something valuable in it, like money, it goes to help build buildings, but also to share the love of Jesus around the world.
Mm-hmm.
Mom, can you hand me the allowance money you owe me?
Go ask your father.
It's me.
Exactly. So, okay, practice holding it up. Yes. Ready? Lower it back down. Cut.